officers, I have a legal mediation agreement. My kids have been held out of state.
You were also criminally trespassed over the phone. You are
asked an officer to come here last night to do a check-in because I'm worried they're in danger.
But you came over here after being told that you were criminally trespassed.
But I have an agreement saying
from this residence, correct?
But my order says that it's my time with my kids. They're supposed to be in Arizona. My husband's kept them out of school.
You were trespassed from this location.
I just need my kids, and
no.
You're welcome to look at this order. They've been out of state, out of school, and my husband's lied to everybody. I'm sure he lied to the cop last night.
We've been in contact with...
Do you have a victim's advocate I can speak to in the police department, please?
Okay.
Melani, so where did you get this order from?
So this is our mediation order.
Okay.
I also have another copy of the original copy of the court. This is my time with the kids. My husband's been hiding with them over a month out of state.
Yeah, we talked to you the other day, right?
Yes. So I asked for somebody to come in and check in on them to just make sure they're safe because my ex-husband will not talk to me.
So we told you they were safe yesterday, right, on the phone?
You said
we
said that on the phone, but they are supposed to be in my custody right now. Yeah, they are. There's no.
Okay, hey, right now, we're working through something else, okay?
Yeah,
so he's
inside,
lied
we'll
to everyone saying
to
he has.
Moment, okay?
He said he's had a protection order against them, and there was nothing. I've never been served with anything. He's lied to everybody, and he kind of does
what,
this. So
what were you wanting to happen tonight? Coming over here, were you going to try to take the kids away from them, or what's going on?
No, I'm not taking. I'm just trying to show that I was going to bring this copy to them and say this is my time with the kids.
Okay.
He's had them out of state, and he's been lying to everyone's protecting them. Like I know, they're nice. My in-laws are nice people, but they've been lied to, saying that there's a protection order in place, and there isn't. My kids are, I'm worried they're in danger, because my husband's been doing a lot of things that cause me to worry. He says he was shot at a month ago, and then he went into hiding, and no one in Arizona has seen him for weeks, or my children, and he kept them out for over a month with truant absences. I asked an officer to just come over here last night to just make sure they're safe. And he said, I can't do a welfare check or a wellness check.
So did you not hear me when we were talking to you on the phone the other day and said we came here because you were here. We came here, we checked on the kids, they were okay.
Are you talking about yesterday or the day before?
The day before.
And I had to call in because I didn't know if that was, I just heard something on speaker. I didn't hear everything I heard it wasn't super clear. And so I called in the next day and I said, I don't want to have to go over there again. Can you send an officer to come check in?
Came over here anyways when we told you that you
well,
were
I have
trespassed
a,
from the...
Well,
it doesn't
I have
matter,
legal,
right?
Well, my children are inside,
I understand
and they're
that,
probably
right?
in danger.
They're probably in danger? You know that for sure? Like.
Well, I know what my ex is capable of, and he has a lot of evil people working with him, so I just wanted to make sure my kids were safe last night. And
so,
the officer...
So do you think
so
this
I need
was
to speak to a
right,
victim's advocate.
Okay.
If you
I'm
can,
just... But you were trespassed, correct? You remember that on the phone?
I asked you if you understood. You said that you did. So.
Okay.
So you understand you're trespassed, right?
Yes, but I believe with my order, I can come and just get my. I'm
nope.
not going in.
Nope.
I'm not
no, that's
going
that's,
into the house.
Nope.
I'm just.
You're trespassed from the property. You being on the lawn right now is a violation of that trespass.
Well, I can get off.
Well, it doesn't
just,
really matter
nope.
now.
I'm not trying to barge into their house. Run and take my I'm just trying to be peacefully, trying to do what's right and what's in my order.
Is this an order from Arizona?
Yes, it is. They're illegally out of state right now. Like, he's keeping them out of school for over a month. I've been searching for them. I don't know what else to do. I asked someone to just come over and see if they're safe last night. And Carlson probably scared them off, saying there's a protection order, and there's no protection order. We can go and look everything up right now.
Okay.
I haven't seen or talked to my kids. I have a 2-year-old, 4-year-old, a 6-year-old, and a 9-year-old. And they haven't seen their mom for over, and my husband's been doing drugs, and he's...
Well, this is probably not the best way to go about it, right? To come here and try to...
I tried asking if an officer could just make sure they're safe.
I understand that, and we told you
they
were safe,
right? But I was told, I have this court order saying it's my time with the kids. If I know where they're at, I can go and get them.
No, so you can't come over here and forcefully take them.
I'm just
going to
give them an order because
out,
I know
right?
they've been lied to, saying
okay.
there's a protection.
That's something that you're going to have to take up with the courts, right? Like we told you the other day. You're going to have to go to
I don't know if they're safe, and I feel like they're in danger.
We can go in there and check and see if they're safe. And then we can come back here, and we can tell you they're safe. Stop talking, okay? We can go in there, check if they're safe, but we already trespassed you from this property saying you can't come back here. And what do? You came back here. And it doesn't matter if you got this piece of paper. We told you not to come back here, and you come back here, and you're upsetting everybody, and now it's just a whole freaking problem. So your whole thing is here is you want to come here and check if they're safe? You want a welfare check on them?
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Well, and it's my time.
Yeah, so that's another problem, right? So this is a whole civil problem. This is a whole court thing, okay? Because even if you do come here with these papers and say, yep, it's my time, they're not giving them back to me, then the only thing you got to do is go to the courts and you got to say, hey, listen, if these are signed by a judge down there in the court or whatever, he can say, you know what, this is your time, let's get this back in court, let's have him come back to court, let's do this, then we can give you a report number, and we can stop talking, okay, I'm explaining some things, okay? Are you understanding what I'm saying?
I am, sir.
So this isn't the best way to go about things.
Yes, sir.
You can bring up everything to the judge. You think he's doing drugs and that he's been getting shot at and that it's not a safe environment for your kids. But what you can't do is come to a place where you've been trespassed.
Yes, sir. I just thought with my order, then I can it's okay. Thank you.
So now there's a bigger problem here because we trespassed you and you weren't supposed to be on here and you're causing alarm to them and everything like that. Who's your judge down there? You don't know your judge? Who signed your papers? Where'd you even get these papers from?
They were mailed to me.
You live in Arizona?
Yes, sir.
Was this done in mediation or in court? Because I don't see anything.
It's a court ordered. So
I don't see anything signed by a
judge.
That's
what I was looking at.
I have the copy with more signatures if you need to see that. This was just for them. I was just bringing them to them because I know they've been monitored.
This is a mediated settlement agreement, not a court order.
Yes, the court mediation was.
Well, if it was done through mediation, it's not through the court. That just means that you guys sat down with the mediator, you agreed on something. This is not something that's been enforced by a judge.
It has, sir. I have the paperwork.
So you guys went to court, you
yes,
sat
sir.
There with the judge
yes,
made
sir.
A determination.
Let's grab that real quick so
yes,
I can see
absolutely,
what kind
sir.
Of judge that
and
is.
And I have a, yeah. Is there a way, sir, for him to check, like with a picture or something, just to make sure it is stuff?
What, you don't believe us that we can go in
no,
there and
sir,
check
I,
their well-being or
no,
what?
No, sir, I just, they have tons of cousins over probably and I just want to make sure that it's my kid.
We'll make sure. We're not here to lie to you or just make sure that your kids are not being
no,
taken
sir,
care
of.
That's a huge
no,
deal
sir,
to us,
I don't,
right?
I don't think you would lie to me. I just want to make sure.
Kids
like,
are
you don't know anything
yeah, in the state of Utah, kids are a big deal. So, like, you take that thing seriously. So, we're going to check out the kids' well being. We're going to do that. We're not just going to tell you something. That's not true. Where's your car? Behind the truck?
Yes, sir.
Anybody with you?
Yes, sir.
What's his name?
Alex Cox.
Well, someone's got to be.
You guys still married? Your divorce is final? When was it finalized?
October, January, October.
Wow, here?
Yes. So, beginning of the 15th, we didn't have any mediation orders mailed out.
Have you been back to the court since he's left the state of Arizona?
I would love to speak to a victim's advocate. Okay. I am not safe.
36, code 4.
Home in Arizona?
I'm not, and so I had to. I've just been looking for them. It says in here to not go straight to filing court since there's a process that we both of you have to go by. We're supposed to contact each other first, and who has any contact.
So if you guys haven't been doing that, then
so there's a whole order. So I was just trying to do things the right way. I don't want all this drama and just trying to file something, what I heard. I don't know, because I couldn't be at the house. I didn't feel safe. Just having followed. I tried to do the best I can. I'm just going about this. I don't know. I've never done this before. Like, I don't.
Okay, so the proper thing to go about this is, you know, when all things else are failing, what you got to do is go to the court. You got to see a judge. You got to do the whole court stuff.
Yeah,
does
but
that not make sense, or what do you want?
No, it's a long process. Like, he's been hiding with them for a month.
That's right. But
like,
if
how
they're
do I
hiding and you can't get in contact with them, you're doing all this stuff, and the next step is to go to court and do all that stuff, right?
I couldn't safely do that, and so I just
can't safely go to court.
No, I couldn't safely go to the
Hello?
I just had a question. Were you guys looking at my car as well?
Nope, you're good.
Oh, okay.
You can keep on going, man. You're good.
Yeah, that's possible, but,
It says that you guys are going to mediation.
We do. It's in here. It's just a blank.
It says
there's a ton.
Flexible parent time.
No, we have.
It can be changed at any time. That's what it says.
We have set days, set weekends, and so we did set all of that.
Well,
and
maybe
a lot
in
mediation
you did, but in the court order, it doesn't specify a specific time frame or a set schedule. It says that you have agreed in mediation to a flexible parent plan, which can change at any time. There's no set time for parents.
Okay, what do you recommend for, like, he's been hiding with them for over a month? Like, that's not allowed. He's out of state with them. He's kept them out of school. They just got unenrolled from their school in Arizona.
So, like I'm saying, we're not going to force the kids to come with you. We're not going to drag them out or take them or whatever like that. So, what I'm telling you is that you need to go to the courts as soon as possible. And I know it might take a little bit of time. It might take a little bit of time and stuff like that. But that's
so
the best way.
I ask you something. If they go in there and they're not all in there, then what happens?
Mm-hmm.
We'll have to find out where they are. We'll have to check
on
them.
Right?
Yeah, that's why I said. Okay. That's why I said you checked on them and they were all good. But the problem is that you're coming here and you're causing alarm.
I'm not sure.
And when we told you, you weren't allowed onto that property.
Right, but if I have this and they have my children, they have no right to my kids. That's the in-laws. They're not even with the husband. So is that an issue? He's there right now.
Yeah, I talked to him. Like,
Brandon Boudreaux is there.
I don't know if he's there right now.
So they're in there. The in-laws have no rights
to
the kids, right?
Argue.
I don't want to.
Okay.
I'm just trying to.
So what you asked me is what you need to do, and if everything's what you're saying is
so
true.
So file kidnapping that they're out of state with in-laws who have no rights to the kids.
I'm getting really pissed off right now that you're not listening. Want to listen to what I have to say, or do you want to just go yourself away and then you can just say what I'm going to say?
Sorry, I'm not trying to understand.
Same one, right?
I'm not. We deal with a lot of these things.
I'm about to mess around with that.
I've done everything right so far.
The problem is that our hands are kind of tied when it comes to, like, civil papers like this and civil matters, right?
How do we protect the kids?
So we can go in there and we can check their well-being and make sure they're okay and everything. If we don't see anything that's, like, wrong with them, or if they're, you know, we can ask them and check on them, are you guys okay, whatever, and they're like, yeah, we're fine, we're totally fine. And then that just rules us, you know, our kind of thing is kind of just,
oh, so he is here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, they're okay.
Yep.
Did you check on the kids?
Okay, cool.
So get that shit out of here.
Yeah. It's time. It's time. It's time to sight and move on. Yep. That's what I'm saying. But
we're not taking them away from them. We're not gonna forcefully give them. We're not gonna do all that stuff.
Did you talk? Everybody's safe. Everybody's safe, and that's not even binding or legal yet. So, quite frankly,
how is it not legal?
Because it hasn't been signed. And it hasn't been submitted by your mediator, okay?
Facts are,
I don't want to see it. I actually don't want to see it. Facts are, I think you should get a citation right now for trespassing.
Okay.
And then we should move on.
Okay.
You want me to do it before you get it?
Sure. I haven't really done anything, so.
Yeah, it's hard to.
Ask you a question, sir?
Yeah.
Officer? How do you know that it has not been submitted to the court systems?
Apparently that's the conversation that your husband had with the mediator.
So if I pull up the superior court and it shows record that it has been, that's the story he's been telling, sir, but that's not the truth.
Okay. I mean, you have an actual record that it's valid right now?
I do, sir.
I mean, it doesn't matter. I mean, you're not going to get the kids out of here tonight anyway.
Sir, I just want to make sure they're safe.
They're safe. I just saw all four of them.
Do you have their pictures? Like, how do you know it wasn't a cousin?
How do I know it wasn't a cousin?
Do you know what their pictures look like?
Do I know what their pictures look like? Well, I don't know what the kids look like, but...
So how do you know that was them?
How do you know that there's four kids in there?
Because the officer said that all four of my children...
Was it a two-year-old, a four-year-old, a six-year-old, and a nine-year-old? Right? Three boys, one girl?
No, two boys, two girls.
Two boys, two girls?
Sir, the youngest, is there a picture you can take to confirm?
Was the youngest one a girl?
Yes.
And then, so that would be your two and your four-year-old a girl?
No, boy.
Boy.
Blonde, curly hair, dimples, blue eyes.
Yeah, they're all in there.
There a way that...
I'm not going to go start snapping pictures of kids.
There have tons of cousins over there. How do I know
there's
that's
tons
them?
Of cousins over there? Right now, you know for
probably
a fact there's tons of cousins up there. You can argue with me all day. You're not going to win.
Okay. I just would love to speak to a victim's advocate.
There's four children in there that are happy and healthy. Okay?
I hope so.
Two of them are playing Fortnite, and the other two are watching Frozen. Is there anything else you want to know?
Can you just take their word that it's not filed in court, because I have legal documents saying that it was filed in court and signed by him, by the judge, by our mediator. So you just take it right here. I've been trying to show it to you.
Doesn't matter. I mean, again, still doesn't matter.
I mean, you can do whatever you want, but I'm just here.
I'm gonna do whatever I want.
I know.
The facts are that I'm not just gonna go in there and remove the kids from the home.
You can do whatever you want.
So if it was filed on October 22nd.
Yes, sir.
Why
am I here now?
Are you here now?
Sir, on October 16th, our mediator went into file, and then Brandon went into hiding with my children. They've been out of state for over a month, out of school, and I've been looking for them everywhere. Somebody said that they've seen Brandon, but not the kids, so I don't know if he split them up different places. Their schools have unenrolled them now. He's not supposed to take them out of state, and he's broken everything he's agreed. He's lied and said that it hasn't been filed, and then he lied and said he has a protection order. And there's nothing that has been filed, and we can look it up. I have it on my phone as well, the Superior Court.
So whether or not, I mean, obviously
36 code 4.
It may be filed or it may not be filed. I don't know. Whatever.
Sir, I sent an officer over here last night doing a welfare check, and they completely. And then he said, "I'm happy to go do it." And then he called me and started like the tone totally changed. Like they're lying about what orders are in place. They're legally not supposed to be out of state right now. They're not. I don't even know if Brandon is there. They're not even in the care of either of their legal guardians.
Yeah, but they are safe. But they are safe, and they're taken care of. So we're not just going to go in there and remove them from the house.
Even though they're not with a legal guardian.
Absolutely.
In-laws.
Absolutely not. No way. No way. I mean, you guys got all this other stuff going on. Like, if the kids are safe, we're not going to take them out of the house. It's just that simple. And, furthermore, it's a civil problem that we can't do anything about anyway. Does that make sense? Like, this is a custody thing. There's not much we can do with custody. All we can do is document that there's a custodial interference, and that's it.
If there's a way to get a picture, just make sure that they're there and see.
I'm not going to go in there and disturb them anymore, okay? They already don't want to see a cop. Okay? They don't want to see a cop.
If he kept to this order, we wouldn't be doing this.
All right, but I'm not going to go in there and stir things up even more.
I'm their mother, and I haven't talked to them for a month.
I get it.
They let me know for sure if they're safe.
I just let you know for sure they're safe.
I don't know if those are cousins over there.
There's nobody else in that house. There's nobody else in the house. So if you're telling me that you know for a fact there's 15 people in that house right now having some sort of family get-together, you're out of your mind. Because there's not anybody else in that house. Nobody. Honestly, your best option right now is probably just stay away from here. Because what's going to happen is you're going to end up in jail. At some point in time, we'll just end up taking you to jail.
Probably not before my ex-husband.
Okay? There's honestly that custodial things, there's like nothing that you can do about it. Nothing. Not a thing.
Sad.
I get that it's sad, but you can't all come over here. One, you've been told not to. Two, you're not kidnapped by their own parent. He has just as much right to them as you do.
No, he doesn't. He legally says that it's my parent. He's been fighting with them out of state. He legally has broken everything.
Are you guys still married?
No.
Well, then you guys have both got conflicting stories, and at
right,
this
and
point,
I have proof. I'm not
they're,
up with stories. I'm telling you the truth,
they're in a
they
safe home, and I'm just not going to remove it. Nobody's going to remove it. So you can sit here and argue and do all that stuff, bring this guy over here, if I'm going to be in here.
I have a feeling under which one.
Where are you staying right now? Where are you living?
I'm living in Chandler, Arizona.
How long have you been out here for?
Utah?
Yeah.
I came out here on Tuesday. Several hours away, so I don't want to be around here. I'm trying to just figure out the right thing to do.
Several hours away, right?
I went to Idaho and back.
You really drove to Idaho yesterday?
4 or 5 hours.
And then back.
That's it.
Why would
I got my order and I came back because he says it's my time with the kids. He's broken everything in here. Sir, you can look at this and say they are not to be removed from the state of Arizona. They're out of school.
I believe. I think you guys have some problems going on right now.
Sure, and I just want to make sure that it is my four children.
Here's the thing, is I'm not going to do anything to make this okay. Nobody's going to do that, okay? I'm not going to go in there and parade around, taking pictures of these kids. You know,
I can show you a picture and you can just go make sure it works.
Show me a picture. Show me a picture of all four. I see all four. So, show me a picture. Fortnite? Is it hype for me? Alex? You have your ID, I can come in.
Just basically in my back pocket.
Keep your hand over, you can feel that. You can
sure.
Cool.
How's it going?
Pretty good, dude. Not bad. You guys came all the way from Arizona?
No.
Oh, where were you coming from?
Idaho.
Oh, Idaho. That's right.
But
do you live in Idaho?
Yeah, I just moved up there.
From where?
From Arizona.
Oh. What the heck?
Apparently that was too warm.
Idaho's a big change.
It's a good change. It's nice.
Alright, here's your ID back, man.
Thanks, Alex. Appreciate it, man.
No problem.
Well, I'd keep my light out of your face, probably. Yeah. I'm just, with everybody here, we can watch her, and then all of a sudden, she's like, yeah, I got somebody out here. We're like, whoa, just let's make sure everybody's safe and okay. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So
I'm not moving.
Cool.
None of that.
Yeah.
Judge on this dissolution.